Visit isleofwight.co.uk.
Vic King, I'm the secretary of the Harp on Wight International Festival. I'm here with my colleagues Anna, Carol, Tony and Melina. And it's appropriate that we're at Michelangelo's restaurant. It's the spiritual home of Harp on Wight because it was here in 2014 that the idea for the festival was first formulated. And our director, Anna, has a few words of welcome.
Welcome to everyone. So this year would have been our seventh festival since the start. Unfortunately, due to the situation, we will postpone the normal festival to next year. But we don't want to leave you alone. So this year we have organized a virtual festival that we hope will keep you in touch with us. What we miss is really your presence, just to be here all together. We are missing your hugs, we are missing your smiles, but in this way, with a virtual festival, there will be the possibility to keep in touch, and then next year, when the whole festival will be available as normal, so we will recover from all this time. Meanwhile, enjoy this festival. Virtual festival, and I want to thank all the musicians that have supported us and has accepted to collaborate for this festival. And I want to thank also all the musicians of the past and all people that took part of the festival, because this is a festival that has been made year by year with the collaboration of everyone. Every single person has given a detail, has given a step, and has helped us to make the festival as it is now. Thank you very much.
Good evening. I'm Karen Vaughan, Head of Harp at the Royal Academy of Music. We're delighted to be invited by Harp on Wight to take part in your virtual version this year, and I hope it's a great success. Your patron, Anne Denholm, is an alumna of the Academy, and several of our students have enjoyed recital opportunities at the festival in the past. Our Harp department is well known throughout the world for its programme of specialist classes and masterclasses. We aim to prepare our students for anything they might encounter as professionals, be it solo work, orchestral, chamber music, contemporary, jazz, teaching, opera, or early harp. Please look at our website for more details, www.ram.ac.uk. My thanks to the Academy and to Paul Patterson for agreeing to share this performance from a showcase concert in June 2019. The quartet, from right to left, Esther Beyer, Anwen Thomas, Nia Evans and Bianca Beng, is playing two movements from Paul's Avian Arabesques, Legend of the Anchor and Flight of the Phoenix. Do enjoy it.
Thank you. And I'm Professor of Harp at the Royal College of Music in London. When Helen contacted me to do this and also suggest a student from the RCM for this showcase, I thought, what a fantastic idea to help our young harpists who are wanting to go into the profession at this most difficult time where you really need a lot of belief and hope for the future. So I'm more than delighted to introduce Agnese Contadini to you. She is a new master's student who has just arrived in London for our master's program and from Italy. And she will be playing the arrangement on Smetana's Moldau. I hope you enjoy. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you. stars. Amy and the moon, she's on a journey with her harp. Plays for stars in the buzz on Mars.
Good afternoon. My name is Clara Gattacomini. I'm in my last year of Bachelor in Music Performance at Trinity Laban Conservatoire of Music and Dance in London, studying with Gabriella Dall'Oglio. I chose Trinity because the harp class is like a family. We are there to collaborate, share experiences, support each other, and someone's achievement is everyone's achievement. I also chose Trinity because we learn to become independent, to make our own choices and justify them, to think critically, and also to make mistakes and learn from those mistakes. At Trinity, I learned that before going into detail when studying a piece, we need to understand the general picture and structure of it. I am also learning to use my weight, so from the arm and from the body, to produce a sound rather than to use the active muscular movement, which requires a lot more energy and can be harmful as well. I'm also learning to produce different articulations to plug the strings and therefore have legato and staccato, just like it is very clear on the piano. We can exaggerate movements on the harp so that we can hear these differences as well and have faster and slower articulations. I also learned that there's not one way to do things, and that when we learn a piece, we need to decipher what the composer's intentions were. And then accordingly, we can experiment with fingerings and harmonics, dampening, so that we can find what sounds better rather than what is more comfortable to play. Just like on the harp we use four fingers, I'm actually learning to use my pinky as well to pluck the strings or to dampen the strings. I will now perform the Sicilienne Variée by Jean-Michel Damas, written in 1966. And the Sicilienne is a traditional dance in compound meter. And the Sicilienne is written in the form of theme and variations, where the composer really explores many different techniques of the harp. And what I love about the Sicilienne is that sometimes the theme is obvious, and sometimes in other variations it is hiding a little bit, so it is almost like a surprise at each variation. Therefore, I hope you'll have some beautiful surprises. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Welcome to this short presentation from the Royal Northern College of Music in Manchester. My name is Eira Lynn-Jones, and I lead the harp department here. Orchestras, ensemble, and chamber music play a very important part in our activities. I've actually been directing the RNCM Harp Ensemble for over 25 years, and we've had many memorable moments. We took part in a sold-out concert at the Huddersfield Contemporary Music Festival, also broadcast on Radio 3, a celebration concert for the music of John Cage with 20 harps at the Baltic Gallery in Gateshead, and my favourite one of all was playing at the Natural History Museum in London under the dinosaur. We've collaborated with artists such as the Welsh harpist Rhodri Davis, saxophonist Tim Garland, composers Paul Patterson and Catherine Const, and the Scottish Glasach player Katrina Mackay, who is also a graduate of the RNCM. Last year, I was invited to give the opening concert at the Harp on Wye Festival and brought some students with me, and you might recognise some of them today. Catherine Mason, Alice Roberts, Jess Hughes, and Angharad Hugh are going to perform for you. We're going to start with 10 past 2 by Pearl Shertock. Thank you.
We were both at the Isle of Wight last year, and what really stood out to me was the fact that you could meet the exhibitors in person. They were very generous and they let us borrow their harps for concerts and for workshops. We could also try out new repertoire before we bought it. I thought it was really amazing that we could meet in person the people we would normally only email.
And another really amazing thing about the festival was how many different types of music there were and all of the array of genres that were on offer in the concerts and the workshops. This next piece that we'll play is an example of how we fuse two genres here at the RNCM. It's a piano piece by a classical contemporary composer, Yuruma, which I've arranged in a jazz style for two harps.
Whilst at the Harp on Wight Festival, we were all very lucky to take part in a jazz harp workshop led by Monica Stadler. And while we were there, we really enjoyed exploring Ryde as a town and meeting all the lovely, friendly local people.
Here at the RNCM, playing in a harp ensemble is a big part of what we do. We really love working as a team, and we will finish by playing Black is the Colour, which is a folk song arranged by Alice.